Welcome.
In the name of God, the most compassionate, the most merciful. I want to thank you for the invitation to speak to you here, although my primary desire and blessing in coming here was just to come and be part of this gathering and to share in our grief and to share in our sorrow and to share even in our anger. But I feel privileged that I feel was welcomed here and that I was welcomed here as someone who was a friend and part of the family. I have to say, going on based on what Fawzia just said, as someone in the Muslim community, you know, I grew up, in my family there are LGBT people. In my Muslim community that I have at DePaul University, where I'm the imam, we have wonderful LGBT Muslim students who have spoken to me. And so we can never forget about the LGBT community among the Muslims, which is often invisible in this debate, which becomes whether the Muslims and the queer community are allies of each other or not. And many times they're beautifully allied with each other, but the reality is that makes the people who are in both of those groups invisible. And so I'm glad to make them visible and to come here today. We mentioned that we hear, and you wake up in this beautiful month for the Muslims of Ramadan when we're fasting and praying and coming closer to Allah and trying to be gentle with each other and compassionate with each other and mindful of God and peace. To hear these numbers, it shocks the conscience. But it's like so many other numbers, the weekly numbers after every weekend that we hear of our brothers and sisters gunned down here in Chicago, the daily numbers that I hear of bombings in Syria and Iraq, and refugees drowning in the sea. And all of these numbers that we keep hearing, that sometimes we just go on with our day after hearing them, what changes it from being just a number to something that can bring out this sorrow and this compassion? And what happens is that it's the love that people have talked about. When you love someone, that's when you realize that that person is a whole world in themselves. That person. And this is a beautiful concept. When I heard someone speaking about that, I was like, that's such a beautiful concept, and it's such a beautiful reality, because we each know that ourselves, we're a whole world. We're a complicated world of history, and different identities, and experiences, and people we love, and people we have difficulty with, and everything. And we can't imagine that that whole world would just disappear. And so when you love someone, and you realize that they're a world just like you, and then when they are taken away from us, we are left wondering, can that whole world just disappear? And in the Quran, it repeats something which was revealed to the Jewish prophets as well, to say that when someone, God revealed, that is why it is if when you kill one person, as if you've destroyed the whole world. As if you've killed all of humanity. It is equally disgusting, it is equally as oppressive, it is equally as painful for all of those left behind. And so we have to stand with everyone here against all the violence and against all the oppression. And we have to stand as allies and defenders with people who are being oppressed. And so that's what I call on all of us here today to do. Your being here shows that you're committed to do it. I call upon all of us Muslims to live up to our charge to do that. And one of my favorite verses of the Quran, God asks us, He says, and this is such a beautiful thing, because sometimes, I know this has been a beautiful mixture of faith and other expressions, and people, everyone here may have their own particular faith relationship or beliefs or identity. And sometimes you get caught between people like myself who know in times like this, the only place we can turn for comfort and the only place we can turn for solace is our faith. And you have other people who say, who want that to be a cop-out, who look at that as a cop-out, and say that we have to turn to action. We can't just turn to comfort ourselves with the idea that there's something beyond this. But why I love this verse is because it shows what we all here know, is that there's no contradiction between the two. The verse of the Quran says, What is the matter with you? This is God talking to us who's reading it, saying, what is the matter with you that you do not come to the defense of those people who are oppressed and who are calling out, oh, our Lord, help us from these people who are oppressing us? And what I love about that ayah is that the people who are being oppressed, the people who are suffering, the people who are being killed, they're turning to God and they're saying, oh God, please help us. Please send us a protector. Please send us someone to assist you. And God is turning to us and saying, what is the matter with you that you do not answer their call? We are the answer to those people's prayers. We are the ones who have come to assist them, to protect them, and to help them. May God be with all of you, and may God be with all the oppressed and needy.
Together with the resolve that can only come from the kind of grief we feel today, We will continue to win hearts and minds and respect for equality across our country. We're calling on people who may not feel personally connected to our community, to the LGBT community, to revisit those beliefs and understanding of who we are. And for each of us in the community, let's make sure that we are never erased in our identities or made invisible by politicians or hate mongers, oftentimes the same person. Let's make sure that the world sees us and knows us and understands the challenges we face each day and make this world a more perfect union. Thanks.
Thank you. Rabbi Shoshana Conover from the Temple Shalom to remarks, closing remarks.
We are taught in Psalm 89, Olam Chesed Yibaneh, which means that this world will be built on love. Olam Chesed Yibaneh, this world will be built on love. Olam, which means world, it also means eternity. Eternally, we will be building this world on love. Chesed, loving kindness, this will be the way that we build a righteous world. Yibaneh, it will be built. Not that it is built now, but it will be built along into our future. Olam chesed yibaneh. This world will be built on love. And yet the world cannot build itself. We must commit to building this world on love. So Abdul, Joy, if you will join me here in your commitment to build this world on love, please join me. Mona, we need people who will help us to build this world on love. Carol, we need our politicians to commit themselves to building this world on love. I ask you, Toni, it's wonderful for you to be here to build this world on love. Mayor Emmanuel, to build this world on love. Our aldermen, to help us to build this world on love.
other, for creating community. This is what this community center was built for. You've blessed it with your presence and your love. Thank you for coming out. I want you also to look at the politicians who are here today, right now. They stayed this whole time. I want you to look at them. Give them a shout out. Closing from him. So much love to you. Thank you all for coming out and our